In this video, we'll talk about genetic diseases and disorders that are caused by having an abnormal number of chromosomes, or abnormal structure to those chromosomes. So what happens when there's an abnormal number of chromosomes, or when the structure of chromosomes are atypical? Well, they cause a variety of genetic disorders. These genetic disorders are less common, and unfortunately, usually lethal. Now, there are two main categories when it comes to inherited chromosomal abnormalities, and those are changes in chromosome structure, or changes in chromosome number. An example of a genetic disease caused by a change in chromosome structure is Cri du Chat syndrome. This is the result of a chromosomal abnormality. It has been linked to deletions of the top portion of chromosome 5. Now, when I talk about deletion of a portion of a chromosome, we aren't talking about just one gene. We're talking about tens, even hundreds of genes missing. Now, the reason why the syndrome has its name is due to the characteristic meowing sound that infants with this disorder have. In fact, cri du chat is French for cry of the cat. Now, this is a very serious, severe genetic disorder, which results in slow growth, tendency towards severe mental retardation, and some consistent physical features like a small head and low-set ears. Now, individuals with this genetic disorder usually don't survive much past adolescence. What about changes in chromosome number? Well, non-disjunction is the term for errors during meiosis. These errors can result in an abnormal number of chromosomes in the daughter cells. These errors occur when homologous pairs or duplicated chromosomes fail to separate in meiosis 1 or meiosis 2. Here we see a karyotype of a human female who has Down syndrome. Down syndrome, also known as trisomy 21, is caused when an individual has three copies of chromosome 21 instead of just two. Now, the incidence of Down syndrome increases with the age of the mother due to a particular characteristic of the human reproductive system, in that females are born with all the egg cells they will have for their entire life at the time of their birth. So, as the mother ages, the cellular machinery that allows these chromosomes to separate is also aging. Now, with that said, just because a child has Down syndrome or another genetic disease or disorder, it doesn't mean that it was the mother's gamete which had the improper number of chromosomes. There is an error rate in the production of sperm as well. It just doesn't correlate with age in the same way that it does in females. What about having an abnormal number of sex chromosomes? Well, extra X and Y chromosomes are possible. It's the genes on the Y chromosome that actually determine whether an individual will be biologically male or biologically female. And so, individuals who are XXY, these are males who have Klinefelter syndrome. They have normal intelligence and lifespan. Those aspects aren't impacted. But they do have some more feminine characteristics, will have smaller testicles, and reduced fertility. Now, females who have three copies of the X chromosome, or males who are XYY, for these individuals, the changes are so subtle that they would likely have no idea that they have an abnormal number of sex chromosomes, unless a genetic test was done. However, for these individuals, there may be reduced fertility because of their abnormal number of sex chromosomes. Individuals who have one copy of the X chromosome and no other matching sex chromosome are going to be biologically female. They have a condition known as Turner's syndrome. Now, individuals with Turner's syndrome, they will have reduced stature, and there's also a possibility for webbing of the skin between the shoulders and the head. there could be a variety of other additional symptoms as well. Now, if there start being drastically different numbers of sex chromosomes, like 3Xs and a Y, or 4X chromosomes, then there will be more serious issues, including mental retardation and sterility. But in general, having an abnormal number of sex chromosomes is far less detrimental than having an abnormal number of autosomes. With that, it ends our discussion on inherited chromosomal abnormalities. Now we're going to spend a little bit of time talking about the human reproductive system and how it relates to inheritance. See you in the next video.